by Ronnie the Rhino and Iestyn Harris, and we'll go through the lead side. And it's number one, Iestyn Harris, the fullback and captain. It's Sterling, Blackmore, Godden, Cummins. Halfbacks are Tony Kemp and Graham Holroyd. And it's in the forwards, Mario Masella, Ryan Sheridan, Darren Fleary, Andy Hay and Anthony Fowler. They retain their places from a spectacular performance away at St Helens, and Daryl Powell loose forward. And on the bench, could there be a stronger bench in the country? It's Mark Glanville, Barry McDermott, Adrian Morley and Marcus Centenaire playing against his former club. And looking at the Huddersfield Giants, at fullback it's Danny Arnold, and then it's Andy Cheatham, Craig Weston, Paul Loughlin, Dean Hanger, Phil Beavers and Steve Booth make up the halfbacks. In the forwards, it's Leeds old boy Neil Harmon, Danny Russell, another former Leeds player in Jamie Fields, Jeff Widenberg and Tony Bowers make up in the second row. Loose forward, it's Matt Sturm. And then the substitutes for the Giants, Gary Schofield has gone for Chris Orr, Paul Cook, Dave King and Adrian Moore. Well, Phil, it's going to be a good game out there.
Yeah, you mentioned Gary Schofield there, and he's just walked across the pitch from the South Stand dressing room. He's sitting up here high in the stand to keep an eye on things. But what an ovation he got from the Leeds crowd. And again, just shows the close links between the two teams tonight. There will be no love lost, but there's a lot of friendships being renewed in battle tonight as well. And again, the opening 20 minutes, we say it every week, are always crucial in these games. Danny Russell leads on the Giants. It's going to be an almighty clash that first 20 minutes, and Huddersfield are going to be up for it. It's a question of how Leeds respond and cope with that different kind of pressure that Dean was talking about.
I expect some huge hits in this first 20 minutes, Phil. There's a lot of big forwards out there. When they collide, you want to stand back and just hear the boom go off some distance away from LS6.
I don't think we're going to need an effects microphone tonight for some of the clashes out there in the front row particularly.
That's certainly one thing that you can never accuse this year's Super League of being. No, there's no quarter given and no quarter asked for out there. These are full-time professionals who've worked very hard over the winter months to make sure they're the best out there, and they're going to prove it. It doesn't matter whether you're bottom or top. When this game kicks off in the next couple of seconds, it's then when it counts, and for the next 80 minutes after that. So Graham Orwood replaces the ball in these round of sand. And he's just looking to get the game underway. Referee John Connolly checks with both teams and starts the game. And it's a big kick from Graham Orwood. It just drops to the 20. And as we take it up, good defence from Leeds, well up there. Craig Weston away. First run for Neil Armin, he runs straight into Marty Masella, and that's a big hit already there.
First clash of the Giants.
Yeah.
Again, another big hit on Tony Bowes, and again, it's Anthony Farrell leading the charge.
You see Ryan Sheridan bounced off the tackle there, and they'll have to make sure these tackles go in first time. Danny Russell again from Dominic, and he gets the kick in. Francis Cummins chases it back. He has a word with Iestyn. The two of them decide. Iestyn takes it on the 10. Going towards the main stand side. Cummins comes back inside. He's jinking his way through. But he's just brought down there.
Interesting that Huddersfield decided there to kick on the third tackle. Danny Russell wanted to get them out of their own half.
Now Richie Blackmore, he takes it up to the 20 for the Rhinos. Just to the right of the post here, playing towards the old scoreboard end. The Eastern Terrace. Andy Hay back inside. Ryan Sheridan organising things there. He gives it to Darren Fleary. Big charge from Darren Fleary. And they're up well there. Matt Sturm gets the tackle in for the Huddersfield Giants.
He also penalised for going slightly high.
Obviously John Connolly will be looking for that there. That'll be a warning to the Rhinos. Make sure they get their tackles in low.
Not only does Leeds' reputation precede them in a lot of these games, but the opposition are going out there to prove who is the strongest. And Graham Holroyd kicks for touch. Leeds could do with making that lesson pay early on.
Now Ryan Sheridan, he gives it out a long pass to Tony Kemp to Holroyd. Holroyd's looking. Hay takes it up. Oh, he's going to break. Oh, and he's just brought down there. And now the Rhinos will look to spread it. Martin Masella takes it up. He's brought down by Jamie Field and Danny Russell. And Neil Harmon all in there, getting the whole front row in that tackle. Darren Fleary turns. Neil Harmon doubles up there.
Yeah, immediately Neil Harmon spotted him. He was straight to him.
Sheridan into Kemp. He switches direction. Bounces off Russell. Offload to Farrell. Farrell getting in inside the 10 now. Five from the line. But we've got John Connolly's going for the knock-on there, Dean.
Yeah, I think Kemp was very unfortunate there because he actually ran into a Huddersfield player who was offside, and he was hoping to get a penalty, but the referee didn't see it that way.
And it's early exchanges to the team, two teams here, cancelling each other out. And the Giants take that scrum and try to move up. They're 15 away from their own line.
Again, it's the pace of Steve Booth straight off the base of the scrum that Leeds are going to have to watch tonight.
Danny Arnold takes it there. He comes up in the middle of the field.
Another player we didn't mention much in the build-up, but got great Super League experience, championship and cup winners' medals with St Helens.
It's another big hit there. Darrell Powell knocked backwards, but Ryan Sheridan clears it up.
And Paul Loughlin was the recipient of that as Neil Harmon takes the charge.
Neil Harmon goes to see an old teammate of his, Graham Holroyd, who brings him down to the turf. That's 40 out. And again, the Giants kick to this left-hand side. And it just trickles out of play on the 20 for the Rhinos. And a couple of good sets defensively for the Rhinos there, though.
Yeah, I think it was a good set, especially the last one defensively. Huddersfield only gained about 35 metres at the most. But they do have to watch Danny Russell. He is a danger man tonight. I've been very impressed with him. And he actually, a bit of history, he actually played for Carlisle. My dad brought him over when he was playing for them. And he actually said to me at the time that he would make a Super League player, and it's turned out to be right.
Certainly he's been playing well for the Giants, consistently their man of the match, even though they've been in some reverses so far this season. Harris now looks for a break. He's just brought down the Rhinos 20. He nearly saw a gap there. It closed on him. Now Blackmore, he takes it up. He's looking to make 10. He offloads to Holroyd. Holroyd across, finds Brad Godden. He's looking for another try. He finds Francis Cummins outside him. He jinks back inside. He's back inside. He's just brought down just over the halfway there, 5 yards over halfway. Anthony Farrell in at dummy half there, and dearie me, Steve Booth, I think it was, tried to go through there and he couldn't, just knocked it down. That's another six for Rhino.
Yeah, I know he's quick, but I mean, that should have been a penalty to Leeds. He was offside. He'd taken off from the marker position, from the first marker position, and got his hand to it. But it's fortunate for Leeds, it's another six tackles.
And they'll enjoy this set of six. They start on the halfway line, just over the halfway line in the Huddersfield half, and Graham Horrell will defeat the scrum. Everything's all in. Francis Cummins has gone across to create an overlap. This could come off. It comes out wide to Harris. Harris to Cummins. Oh no, it's a jink inside. He's gone and he's on the 40. Paul Sterling in at dummy half. He's arcing across the field, looking for a gap. They'll just move it to centre field so they can get some sort of play worked out from there. Sheridan to Masella. Offloads to Kemp. Oh, it's gone behind all the players there. But Fleary picks up. He'll make a good couple of yards. Oh yes, it's a fabulous run from Darren Fleary. He makes up all the yardage that was lost there of that pass. And Hay just offers the dummy but takes it up. Good sensible play from Andy Hay early on. Now Mike Masella, he'll do the same. Yes, it's another 10 metres easily made by the Rhinos there. Ryan Sheridan, 15 out. Finds Graham Holroyd, who's got Harris outside him. A little jink quick. Oh dear, it spilled there by Huddersfield. But Robert Connolly's not interested in that. He's waved it on.
Yeah, he actually done a good job. It was a difficult ball for the winger to take, but it actually bobbled in his arms and he caught it before it hit the ground.
Your eyes sharp in the mind there, Dean. And now Huddersfield take it to the middle of the park.
Again, a good set of six from Leeds, and on the last tackle, pinning Huddersfield down on their own line. They can come up with six big tackles, although Jamie Field gets the ball away and so does Danny Russell. Huddersfield putting in the passes but not making the ground. This is where Leeds need to get on top.
Andy Cheatham doing well for the Giants there. He takes the ball out. And again, Matt Sturm. And they kick early to Huddersfield. This is looking like it's going to go out of play.
And a good kick from Steve Booth there. Again, relieving the pressure. He could see that after three tackles, Huddersfield had only gained maybe 4 metres out their own 10-yard. And he put in a 40-metre touch-clearing kick. And Gary Scoville would be pleased that that's twice kicks have gone into touch and taken the pressure off.
Done well at Huddersfield. They've contained the Rhinos. And really, it's time that the Rhinos began to think about attacking these Giants and making sure that they got through. And it's Richie Blackmore. He takes a big drive up. Now Darrell Powell, his first real run at this Huddersfield defence, and he's made a good couple of yards. He's made 10. He offloads to Darren Fleary. Sorry, Anthony Farrell. And he's still going. He's from Huddersfield. He ain't going to lie down. Now Ryan Sheridan. He jinks his way through. Oh, Mike Masella seems to be taken out there as he was looking for the offload. But Darren Fleary in at dummy half makes a mess. It fumbles around, but he come off his foot. Dalpal but offloads it again to Fleary. He's looking for a gap and he'll find him. He's big enough to get through him. Now Raya Shidden, 40 out. Comes back inside. This is Harris. He's arcing away across, looking for a gap, looking to feed. And here comes Godden. He's past the 30, the 20, taken down on the 20. 17 yards out from the try line for the Rhinos. This is Tony Kemp. He's going to put a big, big kick up there. And Richie Blackmore and Paul Stern and a double team on there. It's come back for Blackmore. Robert Connolly's wiped the tackle count clean. It's back to one for the Rhinos. And Richie takes it down there. And that was a great set of six for the Rhinos. They really worked it well and they'll be hoping to get some attacking options going here. But now in the Huddersfield 20, Kemp across to Harris, who's arced around the back. Godden finds a gap. He could be through here. He's just caught short. 5 yards out. And he falls back to... Well, he gets the offload to Harris. The tackle wasn't made. Harris to Cummins. He'll have to come inside. He does. Now Sheridan finds Hay. Hay, big run from Hay. And we look, the referees look. And that's a try for Andy Hay in the week. He makes it into the England squad. He proves his worth with a fantastic try for the Rhinos that takes him on to lead. More important because it's made them go 4 points up in a tight game so far then.
Yeah, that came after a lot of great Leeds pressure. They completed a good set of six, put a lot of pressure on the line. It's a good ball movement. And then a great kick by Tony Kemp. The winger actually got his hand to the ball and the ball come back down to Richie Blackmore. But a superb couple of tackles, and then a flat ball from the dummy half region. And Andy Hay hit it at pace, and in the end, it was a very, very good try.
Again, a costly hand. I think it looked like Paul Loughlin may have gone up there and tried to get his hand on the ball. Back to Richie Blackmore. He cut inside. The ball moved from the right-hand side through to the left. The combination between Kemp, Harris and Godden is proving difficult for Huddersfield to hold at the moment. Francis Cummins had a run as well, but then the ball brought back onto the inside and a great short ball from Ryan Sheridan. Andy Hay in a rich vein of form crashed over probably about 15 metres from the side of the post. Iestyn Harris stepping up now to try and convert, pushes it through the middle, 6-0 to Leeds.
Good kick from Iestyn Harris. He made sure of that, making sure that the Rhinos get the full weight of their the try with the conversion, adding the points. But that was a good spell for the Rhinos, two successful sets of six, and really the pressure was going to pay, and I hope that's hopefully the way the Rhinos are going to play tonight. They grind out their set of six and hopefully find gaps in this Huddersfield defence.
Well, we talked about the first 20 minutes maybe being important, the first score being important to assert the team that was going to be on top. That's come to Leeds. They can't let the intensity drop now as Huddersfield run the ball out of their own defence.
That's Matt Sturm. He's gone up, but he's taken down by Fleary. Danny Russell will look to use it again. Jamie Field takes it up this time. And Anthony Farrell and Richie Blackmore will double team on him, make sure he goes down. It comes out now. But that's again good defence by the Rhinos.
Darryl Powell leading the charge and Andy Hayes everywhere at the moment. But again, they only need to look at the Leeds bench to see any slight mistake. And I think that's got to be a penalty to Leeds. The referee signalled quite clearly to Dean Hanger he was offside. And he didn't give Francis Cummins the requisite 10 metres from a poor Danny Russell kick.
No, actually, the penalty was, he was actually onside. The penalty was because the player was still in the air. Francis Cummins was still in the air, and he took his legs out from under him, and it could have been a very dangerous tackle.
Certainly very dangerous play there from the Giants, but great to see the Rhinos of Huddersfield have no other option but to kick from their own half. They haven't had any other attacking options so far this half, so far in this game. Fleary gets it up to Sheridan. Marlon Masella, he drives it up the middle of the park. Darryl Powell and Brad Godden seem to be working something out on this left-hand side. It comes this way now, and it's Powell looping around the back. He offloads the Cummins, who comes back inside.
Playing with a lot of confidence, Francis Cummins, not frightened to take the defence on.
All right, to Sheridan, to Masella. He's got Farrell outside him, decides not to use him, takes it up the middle of the park. They're 20 out, bang in front of the post now. Kemp. Oh, that's a good ball to Harris. Harris is going towards the touchline. Sterling has to cut back inside. But he still makes the yards. Now 15 out on the south stand side. It's a slow play, the ball. Kemp across to Holroyd. He's got Powell outside him. He misses him for Godden. Godden with the little kick through. It's a race. Oh, did Graham Holroyd get it?
I think he did. Oh, the referee's given a knock on.
And a knock on. in the act of sliding down the book. Graham Holroyd stuck and he may have knocked it on there.
Yeah, that was unlucky. I think it was Francis Cummins. He followed the ball up and he actually thought the ball was over the line and he pushed it down, but unfortunately it was just short.
And the Giants get a reprieve there and will try to get the ball away. Russell out to field. Oh, that's a big, massive hit there from Darren Fleary. They've become his trademark so far this season. And they'll try to move it now. Danny Russell and Neil Harmon. He's had a relatively quiet start, a few hits early doors.
He won't stop taking the ball up all night, though, and that try would have come off the back of three very long passes, and maybe that's the way Leeds will find the key through on the outside. And Brad Godden, again, in good form tonight.
Jeff Wittenberg doing a lot of work for the Giants at the middle of the park, but they can still only kick from their own half. Iestyn Harris takes in on his 10, makes his way to the middle of the park.
He was looking for another of those long raking passes along his own line that he's thrown out against Wigan and St Helens, but this time elected to hold on to the ball.
Paul Sterling now, he takes it up. There's a lot of work in defence and taking the ball up early in the tackle count. There's Paul Sterling while his forwards get back.
As a feature at Sheffield when Leeds were doing it really tough, wingers Sterling and Cummins coming off to take the pressure off the forwards. Richie Blackmore there doing the same thing.
Graham Murray sent his substitutes out to warm up. A good kick from Graham Holroyd. It's going deep. It's a foot race now between Cummins and Danny Hangout. I think Cummins has got it.
Again, the referee's disallowed it for offside, but I don't think there was much wrong with that. Francis Cummins looked onside to me.
No, I could see the move developing, and I watched Francis Cummins, and he was definitely onside.
And it seems particularly harsh. John Colley taking a very harsh line here tonight. And that's, again, the Rhinos being denied down that end of the field by penalties. And it seems to be...
That was very clever play, though, wasn't it? I mean, it was very early in the tackle count. Graham Holroyd had seen that the Huddersfield winger was up very flat, put a lovely kick in behind him, the bounce went Francis Cummins' way, and it should have been a try.
That's two disallowed tries inside 2 minutes. Let's hope Leeds don't rue those later in the game. But it certainly shows they're creating the chances tonight already. 15 minutes gone and one try on the board and two disallowed.
Russell feeds Windenburg. They look to get it out again now. Steve Booth on the ball. Oh, and it just skips in front. Oh, dear. There's a break now for the Giants. Oh, and it's just picked for the Giants and they're finally getting their feet in this game. Russell across, he's looking to move. Well,
no, it was referee signalling back to six on the call of linesman, but it actually came off a Huddersfield player. So a lot of the calls at the moment just not going Leeds' way, but they've just got to hang in there.
Wittenberg doing another drive. He's 10 out from the Rhinos line, and there's a lot of pressure on the Rhinos. They're giving away another set of six in their own 20. Jamie Field takes it up. He gets a nice warm reception from his former teammates. Russell comes in again. We'll have to watch him from dummy half.
At least 10-0, and then by the same token, could have been 6-all, but Leeds coming away from their own quarter with a penalty to touch.
This move starts on the Leeds 25. Darren Fleary makes the hard yards there. Sheridan to Masella. He takes it up again. He'll never let the work rate slacken while he's on the field. Oh, and Anthony Farrell gets the pass out there and he just spills. It was an awkward pass, but he should have taken it.
Yeah, I think Faz had every right to take that ball. I mean, it wasn't the perfect pass, but it was very catchable and he'd be very, very disappointed in that.
That gives the Giants an opportunity. They have a scrum just 35 metres out from the Rhinos posts. Russell looking to feed. And again, Sturm's come round from the scrum, arced round. And Arnold in the dummy half. He looks to find Hanger. He takes it up. And now 25 metres out from the post. Steve Booth finds Neil Harmon. He turns around back to Booth. It's a good move there. Nearly creates a hole, but Paul Sterling's off his wing there.
Again, Paul Loughlin proving a handful out there on the left-hand side.
Jamie Field spins in the tackle, but he can't get anywhere. Doesn't get him any more yards. looked pretty, but it didn't get him anywhere further. Now the Giants coming across the field, and again, not seem to have clear intentions as to what they're doing there.
Now Phil Vivas just ran a bit too far on the last tackle, didn't give himself an option, and Wittenberg caught in possession, the turnover on the Leeds 10.
So the Rhinos take it back.
Yeah, they just seem to be lost for ideas when they get into the Leeds 20 metre area, and their halves at the moment aren't directing play for them.
We can get on to Bob down there on the Rhinos bench. What do you make of it so far, Bob?
Well, at the moment, I find that when we're going up the middle, that this is where they're seeming to be holding us. But once we put it out wide, we've certainly got the beating of them. So I just think we really need to start throwing it wide all the time.
It's important the Rhinos got that first score.
Yeah, it certainly is. And had we got that second score, which looked a perfect tie to me. But once we get two or three scores in front, I think the game will just open up completely for the Rhinos.
Rhinos, good chase in there. And it's in the hands of the Giants as they come forward. They're up to their 40.
We said 20 minutes would be a good benchmark. We're just coming up to that mark now. It's 6-0 to Leeds. And they've had the majority of the play, but in the last maybe 10 minutes, Huddersfield are launching a bit of an attacking platform. They've got up to halfway with this particular drive. And Jamie Fielders has got the ball out, but it's gone back 8 metres.
Dean does a lot of work there. He takes it back up from where the ball was originally lost. But he seems to be injured. He's on his haunches.
It was the tackle of Farrell and Fleary on Dean Hanger.
It's done for many this year in Super League so far. Bill Fevers gives the pass out to Booth. Oh, and it's knocked on there. Richie Blackmore has it. He's on the halfway line. He's evaded four tacklers. Five come in there. What a man mountain he is. He's done fantastically well there and got a penalty for his troubles. Great work there by Richie Blackmore.
Yeah, I think like Kevin Iroh used to have the nickname here at Headingley as the Beast, but I don't get many more centres as big as strong as Richie.
And he's gained vital yardage for the Rhinos there, getting that penalty. And now they start this move on the Giants' 30. Comes across to Kemp, to Holroyd. He's looking for a move. Harris has joined the line. He offers a dummy, then takes a sensible option there from Harris. Early in the tackle count, Brad Godden takes it from dummy half, makes another 10. That's good work there by Brad Godden. He's looking to continue his rich vein of try scoring form. Oh, gives the pass out there, and it's a bad mistake there, Dean.
Yeah, I think Faz has just got a little bit of grease on his hands or something tonight. That's his second pass in the last sort of 5 or 6 minutes that he's put down.
But it's great for the Rhinos that if Faz is having an off day, you've got the likes of Adrian Morley on the bench, who will obviously take some part in this game later on in the match, of course. One or two Huddersfield Giants fans speckled around the ground. Good to see them here. Good to see an away sport at the ground. Obviously gives the away team a bit of a lift and creates a great atmosphere for all fans. A bit of banter and a bit of light-hearted enjoyment in the crowd as the Giants take it up the middle of the park. They take it 10 out from their own posts.
And they're struggling to make the yardage, but they've just managed to get over the 20-metre line. Looks like Dave King warming up. Dean Hanger may have to come off, although he seems to be walking a bit better after that crunching tackle on halfway.
Barry McDermott going through what looked like latter stages of warming up there on the bench, beginning his stretching exercises.
Yeah, well, I know Barry, what he's doing, and he's doing it for Graham Murray's sake, just to let Graham know that he's keen to get on.
A great insight, and it's the sort of insight you'll only get here on Radio Rhino, 14:04 AM. And the Rhinos have got it back now. Mistake by the Giants. Kemp to Blackmore, the New Zealand combination. He's got Sterling outside him, but he doesn't need him. He can make 10 yards on his own, just with sheer power from those pumping legs. Sterling at dummy half finds Kemp. He finds Anthony Farrell. And he ducks under evades the tackles of the Giants. Minor Micella to Sheridan to Fleary. They're all heading the same sort of direction of the field. It's good early in the tackle count to get these yards made so we can create a creative platform. Holroyd, Jinkin, passes off loads to Powell, out to Harris. Oh, he's got nowhere to go there.
Yes, unfortunately, Francis Cummins went in for the short ball. He didn't get the ball, and the referee has done him for crossing.
But Phil, a lot of pressure early on from the Rhinos, and that's what they need. And unless they've got the pressure, they can't get the points early doors.
Yeah, again, Huddersfield made the mistake of knocking on their own 40. Neil Harmon went as the dummy runner, but the ball hit him, got the pressure back, and within two tackles, Leeds had almost got to the Huddersfield line. Just couldn't find that finish. But whilst ever the play is in the Huddersfield half, then you feel increasingly confident that Leeds are going to post a score.
Neil Harmon takes it up there, and that's a big hit from Andy Hay and Martin Masella that puts him down on the deck. Now Steve Booth arcing across. He finds Matt Sturbridge dropped down, and Tony Kemp's got it, and Tony Kemp make it to the line. It's a foot race now, and he's got five, and he's over. Oh, what a try from Tony Kemp. He capitalised on the mistake, and that's what happened in this year's Super League. A great team like Leeds, you can't make mistakes because you'll be punished, and that was a fabulous try from Tony Kemp. The ball was dropped by Matt Sturm, and Tony Kemp went through, made 30 yards on that run, and it looked like he might have been caught, but he knew where the try line was, and he was going there all the way.
Yes, it was a great work by Tony, a very opportunist try. Showed a good turn of speed, and I'm sure his hamstrings will be straining a little bit at the moment, but to my way of thinking, it was a very strange move for Huddersfield to put on deep in their own half. They tried it the first time, or a version of it, about 10, 15 minutes ago. That didn't work. They had another version, but it involved a lot of sort of sideways movement. And really, you can't afford to play in sideways, especially in your own half.
Again, the cheer you could hear was not so much for the try, excellent though it was, but Barry McDermott has just announced his intentions, come on the pitch, replacing Martin Masella. Again, it was no cover in the Huddersfield back line. That was the strange thing. They seemed to be trying some runaround move. Booth and Sturm knocked on between them. Tony Kemp on hand to pick up the ball, and it was Booth chasing him back, who's one of the quickest players in the league, but didn't lay a hand on him. Iestyn Harris puts over the conversion. It's 25 minutes gone, 12-0 to Leeds, and I think that could be the crucial try.
We hear over the PA here at Headingley, return of the Mac, and it is the return of the Mac, Barry Mac. He's ready to have a big impact on this game, and it'll be crucial first 5-10 minutes for Barry. Make sure he can get himself in this game and raise his standards for this game.
Yes, I agree with Phil there that it could be a turning point in this game. I think Huddersfield's opportunity to score 6 points 10 minutes ago or so when they were deep in Leeds' territory. You know, anything could happen at 6-all, but at the moment they're under a lot of pressure, and Leeds are playing very well.
And Huddersfield have come up with a couple of mistakes in their own half as well, which must give Gary Schofield worries for later on in the game. A good run from Matt Sturm trying to make up for the mistake. He knows he was the culprit, but Barry McDermott's on, and every move of his will be eagerly watched by the crowd.
The Giants now up to their 40. They come through the and want to make it to break the halfway line so early in the tackle count.
And they've got Dave King on, and he's a big lad playing in the forwards. He's replaced Tony Bowes as Vivas tries to launch players up the middle, but there's no change out of Barry there.
Booth running up, using his own teammate to create maybe a bit of huddle, but Darryl Powell's there, and he's far too experienced a player to be caught out by something like that. And Andy Hay makes a break. That's a great run by Andy Hay, across to the halfway line. He pushes off Danny Arnold. He needs support, though. He makes it to the 20. And he makes, that's a great yardage there. If he makes 40, maybe 50 yards on that one run alone. It's great work by Andy Hay. It goes across to Graham Holroyd. He's jinking for looking for a hole. Iestyn Harris in at dummy half now. The Giants slow the play, the ball down so they can get their defence back. But it's Anthony Farrell this time. He takes it up. And he makes another 5 yards on that, ever getting closer to that Giants line. Now Ryan Sheridan, arcing across, goes to Barry Mack. Could this be his first impact on the game? He's over the line, but I think he may be held up there. He's held up on his back there.
Well, because it was a great little grubber through by Steve Booth. Powell got there, picked the ball up, didn't just take the tackle, stood up and freed Andy Hay. Hay went through the hole, and his arcing run included three tremendous handoffs, one on Neil Harmon, two on Danny Arnold, but fortunately for Huddersfield, Arnold made that last tackle stick, and Leeds doing a planned move from the base of the scrum.
Graham Holroyd out to Travis Cummins, and it's as easy as that. The planned move works as if they were doing it on the exercise paddock. Harris arcing round, off to Holroyd. Holroyd in, out to Cummins, and really, when the defence doesn't shift across like Giants, they were caught out there outside, and Cummins just comes under. Maybe he could have even gone under the post to make it a little more easier. But he's touched down, and that's a crucial try for the Rhinos as they take the step up and make gain from this pressure they've had on the Rhino on the Giants.
Yeah, it was a great planned move. It's not the first time they've used that this year, and and again they've scored from it. So it was there's a lot of sort of running off the ball from moves like that, and you know, it's just reward for the pressure they put on.
He gave the perfect pass to Francis Cummins, and that was a walk-in from 10 metres, brought it round to again almost the same spot the first try was scored on, but all came from that great break from Andy Hay, really.
I've got a feeling that they'll be showing that try for some time to come on training videos all up and down the country. Superb, well-planned move, and it shows exactly what can happen when your team are working harmoniously together. And Iestyn Harris converts. A good kick from Iestyn, straight down the middle of the post, as per usual.
Again, the whole complexion of the game changed in the last 3 minutes. Two tries on the 24th and 27th minute for Leeds. Again, out on the left-hand side. There obviously are some weaknesses there on the Huddersfield right. If Leeds can get the ball wide, as they proved brilliantly from that plan move from the Huddersfield 10.
Now the Giants must come back, and they must come big and strong, and they don't come bigger than Neil Harmon as he takes it up. Matt Sturm now, he took it up with Andy Hayes, got him. And Darren Fleary. They look to move it again.
Again, Dave King's a big physical presence out there. Just running slightly wider off the ruck. He could be dangerous. And Dean Hanger's coming off his wing. Oh, sorry, not Dean Hanger. He's still recovering, I think, from the tackle.
Andy Cheatham in there.
It's Cheatham. They came over to take the pressure off.
Saying in the middle of the park.
Great kick in again from Danny Russell. And the referee's given a penalty because he was taken late after the kick had gone. But again, didn't look like there was anything in it.
Oh, that was a tough call. I mean, I think maybe because it was Barry that did it, that the referee singled him out. So, but in saying that, you know, Barry's just got to stay clear of things like that and not give an excuse to the referee at all.
It's unfortunate for Barry. Penalty given, and I'm sure the Giants will look to kick this, maybe get some points on the board. They're having a discussion about it. No, they're going to take it to their credit. They're going to take it up. Jamie Field, he makes the mandatory 10 yards from the penalty. No defence there, so he can easily make those yards. Comes across to Booth. To Vivas, looking Booth running around the back. It's a good move there from the Giants, but didn't make any move and didn't make any yardage on where they had the last play of the ball. Vivas again. He's wrapped up. Three-man tackle there from the Rhinos. Most importantly, no offloads there. You don't need that in your own 20. Russell goes on his own from dummy half. You've got to watch that against him. He's proved the bane of many teams' lives in Super League this year. Good chase in there from Paul Sterling. Came right across the field to get that tackle in. Now Vivas again, going outside. Oh dear, they're in here. Oh, in touch. Great work there by Paul Sterling.
Paul Sterling, where did he come from? He actually, as you say in that previous piece, he chased the winger right across the field. Must have been 30 metres inside. Huddersfield were very smart to notice that. And then from a loose ball, Richie Blackmore got his hand to it. Yeah, who was it that took him out in the corner flag? But Paul Sterling.
Great work there by Paul Sterling. A much maligned, much ignored part of the defensive effort. It's not just the forwards that are putting the big tackles in. It's the like of Paul Sterling's and Francis Cummins out on the wings.
Fantastic tackle on a much bigger man as well, as Darrell Powell knocks on, bringing the ball out. Two knock-ons, although Huddersfield can feel a bit aggrieved that they weren't allowed to play on, but magnificent tackle. I think it was on Paul Loughlin as he picked up and looked like he was strolling into the corner, and Sterling came from his blind side and threw him straight into the corner flag.
Loughlin's looking dangerous on that wing, and it'll be...
It was either Loughlin or Arnold, it was difficult to tell, but Richie Blackmore went for the interception, and I think it may have been Arnold that gathered the loose ball and was
Beavis
caught.
To Booth. Oh, it's a big hit there from Tony Kemp. Now Matt Sturm takes it up. He makes it up to the Rhinos 30.
I think this is a very important set of six for Huddersfield, as it is for Leeds Rhinos. If Huddersfield are going to get back into this game, they need to score from it.
It's a crucial set of six for the Giants here. They're inside the Rhinos 30. Jamie Field takes it up. He'll know every inch of every blade of grass on this pitch from his time here. Phil Viva's coming across. Referee going across to his linesman there. And he's given a penalty. Not quite sure what that was for. Now the Giants there, seven metres out from the Rhinos line. Coming across. Phil Viva's has got it. He looks like, oh, he's just... the Giants are going to have to do better than that if they're to hope to get on the scoreboard in the next before half time. Really, that was their perfect position in the field, and they've just knocked on there.
Yeah, I think it was at number 13 again, is it Stern, that was responsible for Tony Kemp's try. That he put down a, not a difficult pass, and there was plenty of field in front of him.
It certainly wasn't a fast pass, and the conditions are perfect here. There's no moisture or anything. So really should have taken that pass, and that could prove costly for the Giants, as Dean was saying. They really had to get on the scoreboard there. Sheridan feeds Fleary. He makes it over the 20 for the Rhinos. Sheridan to big Barry Mack. Offers the... Oh, that's great offload by Barry to Ryan. Ryan Sheridan there makes it over to the 30. Now Daryl Powell. It was a good little short pass to Brad Godden there. He makes another couple of yards before the tackles come in. Big pass there from Iestyn Harris to make sure Graham Horrell's got plenty of space for the kick. It's a big kick. Danny Arnold looked and collected. He's bounced over his house.
Again, Danny Arnold put his hand up. The ball hit his hand. The referee deemed it went backwards, but dangerous.
Yeah, why on earth did Danny Arnold not try and take that on the full? That baffles me, actually.
Very dry conditions out there. The pitch has been freshly cut for drainage, and the ball will bounce big and hard tonight.
Interesting that Huddersfield bringing on Chris Orr. He's another halfback that they'll hope will mix it up in the middle of the park. Presumably will come on for maybe Phil Vevers. Yep, looks like Vevers coming to the sideline, and Orr's got pace, and they obviously think that Leeds are maybe weak up the middle to pace, as Booth has shown.
Chris Orr, who's had his problems with injuries this season, he'll be looking to have a big game now he's come on the pitch. Oh, that was kicked straight out, Francis Cummins. And he's given, John Connolly's given the scrum to Leeds.
Leeds. Unintentional touch off a Leeds man, but Huddersfield again not getting any depth on their kicks, and that could prove costly.
It's a very mix and match kicking game from the Giants today.
Yeah, I think with the introduction of Chris Hall, he might add something to that. But it's good field position for the Rhinos at the moment, and they've got a good set of six here, and put Huddersfield under a bit of pressure just before half time.
Offload from Harris to Godden. Just gone all the way across the field there. Not much yardage made. Barry McDermott takes a big run now. Oh, that's good work from Barry. You have to make sure he stays in. He does. Goes to ground. Good play by Barry there. Now Ryan Sheridan to Brad Godden. He's looking for a pass. He gets it to Harris. Oh, well, that's... Harris gets the pass away. It seemed to be knocked down by the Huddersfield players.
It was, and Regallagher offside position by Jamie Field.
That was excellent footwork there by Iestyn Harris. As the pass was coming to him, he actually changed direction and had to reach for the ball, and it nearly came off.
Well, that is the nature of the beast. He's a highly skillful player. And it's what we've come to expect from him. Barry McDermott's the dummy runner there. So Farrell takes it in the middle of the park. 15 metres out, directly in front of the post on the Eastern Terrace. Sheridan offloads to Hay, who's having another impressive game as he breaks through, and this could be another try for Hay. Just, oh yes, he could have got it. Oh no, double movement there, I think.
Yeah, that was another great run by Andy Hay. He's taking a lot of stopping, and it was very unfortunate. I suppose it's very tempting to actually put your hand out when you're that close to the line.
As we see Gary Schofield making his way down towards the Giants bench from up here in the main stand.
Again, Leeds scored three tries, had three disallowed so far in this half, which is possibly a fair reflection of the way the game has gone.
This has been a huge test for the Rhinos. They had to come out here. They should have beaten the Giants, so everyone said in the papers and the talk of the fans, but they had to go out there. As Graham Holroyd said at the start of the game, they should win, but they've got no right to win. And they've gone out there and they've proved that they deserve to be three tries in front. They've played well and consistently in this first half without being spectacular. They ground out their set of six and capitalised on errors that Huddersfield have made, and that's exactly what Graham Murray will have hoped from his team. What's he's given knock given here by Giants?
Again, not a happy half for Matt Sturm. He's knocked on again, and fortunately the referee realised that even though there were two men in the tackle, he did just genuinely drop the ball.
Yeah, you're right there. It was a good call from the referee. I think a lot of referees would have actually given a penalty away to Huddersfield there, but he read the situation very correctly.
Good position from the referee, John Connolly, there. he could see exactly what was going on. He'd come back and he was watching the tackle very carefully. It comes out to Harris. He's got Sterling arcing back in. He's found a gap. Ooh, he's just pulled short there. Matt Sturm trying to make amends for his mistake earlier. Sheridan to McDermott, who jinks inside Sturm. Five Giants defenders pulling down Barry Mack there. They obviously see him as a major threat.
Must be a gap somewhere then.
Dale Powell finds out Brad Gordon. He could have found the gap now. He goes. Oh, just pulled short on the 10. Oh, it's a messy, sloppy play the ball there. And Leeds will pay the price, and they do. No need for that there. Obviously looking for a quick play the ball to get the most from any overlap that was somewhere on the park, but they've lost the ball and you won't get any tries while you're defending. And so the Giants get to take it out from their own defence. They make it up to the 25, that's Jamie Field. It
looks like Huddersfield have got an injury problem. The trainer's waving that a substitute needs to come on. I'm sure it will be Paul Cook, because it looks like is it Craig Weston in trouble out there?
Doesn't seem to be. It's hard to see the numbers on this Huddersfield shirt. Poorly designed for the Super League numbers this season. As they come out, now Booth, well, he's caught short. Looking for a pass there that was never going to come. Russell gets a good pass out. Harris chases it back and he takes it on the Leeds 10. And now he takes it up. And Paul Sterling heading towards Paul Cook, but comes in early. And that's a great first half for the Rhinos. Fantastic play that saw them get three tries. The first from Andy Hay, which was converted by Iestyn Harris, followed by a knockdown by the Giants' Matt Sturm. That was capitalised by Tony Kemp, who raced through to score just shy of the post. A great run from Tony Kemp. And as Dean rightly pointed out at that time, Tony will have been feeling that run because it was quite a break and made 40 yards on that. And then towards the end of the first half there, Francis Cummins on a great planned move from the Rhinos from the base of a scrum, coming across, and they break through. Dean, a good half for the Rhinos.
Yes, I'm sure Graham Murray will be fairly happy.
Welcome back to Headingley. It should be a thoroughly entertaining second half here with the Rhinos leading 18-0. Sorry, got to try there. 18-0 lead going into the second half. The Giants kicking off to them. Anthony Farrell takes it up. He makes it up to the 20. It's a good start for the Rhinos. A good place to start this second half. Aaron Fleary. He takes it up again. Yet more easy yardage for the Rhinos. They'll like this early in the tackle count. Holroyd finds Kemp. Good long pass there to find Kemp.
Very strange decision, forward pass, but the referee in completely the wrong place to have seen that.
And we'll see. That's the training referees get. They can spot things when they're clearly in the wrong position. But, that's what he's given. That's why the Rhinos will have to play out 30 metres out from their own posts. They're playing towards the Western Terrace in this second half. Danny Arnold comes back inside.
Again, the half-back combination now of Orr and Booth certainly has pace for Huddersfield, but they'll know that they need to score really in this set of six if they're going to make a game of it.
Or to Sturm, he'll be looking to improve on his first half performance where he coughed the ball up too many times for Gary Schofield's liking. And this comes out.
It's safe to say he's not in the running for man of the match, and then a needless pass from Jamie Field has given possession back to Leeds.
I think that what happens when you've got pressure put on you. You look for things that aren't really there. You become a bit paranoid in possession. Now Barry Mack takes it up. And he makes 10. Oh, he could even make even more. Just pulled back by his shirt. And it gives the other Giants defenders opportunity to swarm all over him. Leary out to Harris. Harris turns to Holroyd. Holroyd hands off Sturm. Well, that's good yardage there by Graham Holroyd. A good run and good upper body strength from Graham to hold off the defender. Now Andy Hay, he'll be looking to carry on his performance in the first half. That good run that saw him high in the tackle count, high in the yardage rather. Now Brad Gordon's come off for the Rhinos.
Yep, Marcus St Hilaire on the wing.
He'll love nothing more than trying to get a try against his old club.
Yes, Graham would be very disappointed with that little chip kick to the winger there. It didn't really put Huddersfield under any pressure. And now I think Leeds have really got to contain Huddersfield down here and just make sure that they maintain that pressure. And just as I say that, a half break here by Huddersfield. The winger's going down the line.
Cheatham cuts back inside, but Sterling, what a man, Paul Sterling. Big hits all round. And it's another try-saving tackle from Paul Sterling. Now Russell try and gets it out. Oh, good, well up there by Francis Cummins. But now the Giants have still got it. Phil Vivas, he tries to make a few yards. He comes back inside to Russell. He's jinking. He'll never give up. The Giants captain, he's got a lot of experience and a lot of pace to burn out there. And Craig Weston, I think it is, tries to make a break around the outside. Danny Irrell's asking for it over here on the main stand side. He's looking for a big kick, I'm sure, but it's coming out to him via the hand. It's a good run there by Steve Booth. Brad Gordon, we're hearing, is a blood bin substitution. So that won't affect Graham Murray's tactical options going into this second half. Unless, of course, he has to remain off the pitch with that blood bin substitution. Iestyn Harris just puts that ball. A little grubber kick there through from Booth. And Harris taking no chances because he doesn't need to really. The Rhinos 18-0 up. Just pushes it out of play. And they'll kick from underneath their own post. Hopefully get plenty of yardage on it. Where Morrow usually takes these ones. No doubt he'll take this one.
Yeah, Gary Schofield will be very happy with his team start in this half. And it's just what they need. They need to put a bit of pressure on Leeds' line, but at the moment Leeds are holding well and their defence is very solid.
And the Giants from that kick out, drive it back, take it up to the middle of the park. But the Rhinos, I wouldn't fancy being on the end of that. It was Fleary, Farrell and McDermott. That was a big hit if ever there was one. And now King, who's been very impressive for the Giants since he came on. Big running outside, but he's brought down by Richie Blackmore. No one's getting around him. He takes it as personal pride, the tackles and the personal insult if you try to get around him.
Yeah, he did knock on there though, and he's given Huddersfield possession again on the Leeds 40.
This is rather dampened down play for the Rhinos in this second half. They've not managed to get much yardage and get a platform for attacking options against the Giants. As we say that, Chris Orr makes a break, but he's just pulled back by Tony Kemp, who's limping away from that tackle, getting back in his place in the line as the Giants look to weigh up their options. Chris Orr again, he's been a good attacking option. Neil Harmon spinning the tackle away from Tony Kemp, but can't get past Fleary, Farrell and McDermott again. Yeah, that's going to be a big partnership for the Rhinos. King again,
great drive. Solicitors.
I think they win a lot of cases.
Again, it's Booth and Aura trying to create things in midfield for Huddersfield, and they are looking lively.
They like this little switch move to the Giants. They've been trying to do it all day. A little drop kick through.
Well taken by Marcus St Hilaire though.
That's good play by Marcus St Hilaire, his first real touch of the ball, and he's alive to it. Often can be the case with substitutes, they're not full up to match tempo, but not the case there with Marcus St Hilaire, who's very quick there and very agile on his feet. Claims there from the crowds that Iestyn Harris was interfered with while on the floor, but Robert Connolly's having none of it. This goes to Holroyd, back inside to Kemp. He's heading towards the middle of the park, 30 yards out from the Rhinos line. He offloads to Harris, Harris to Farrell. Farrell drops it, seems to go backwards, but Robert Connolly says it rocked forward, and that means that it'll be turnover again for the Rhinos.
Yeah, again, there was some good ball movement there, but we weren't going forward. But again, you know, Faz had every right to take that flip pass.
And these will all be going down on the statisticians' error charts.
Is that Darryl Powell hooking? It's like it is.
Chris Orr causing trouble in the middle of the park there. Tony Kemp ordering the Huddersfield team to get up and play the ball quickly. Bit of old man tactics there. Coming across, Tony Kemp still out there looking for the tackle. He gets it again. Good work with Paul Sterling. Marcus St. Hilaire on that side now. It comes across the Giants again, lacking ideas, but they manage to get the offload to Jamie Field. He heads through. He's got McDermott and Sheridan on him, but then Russell comes again. He's jinking run. He's got Arnold outside him. He's looking to get up to Arnold. Arnold, he offloads to Arnold. 5 yards out. Arnold to Cheatham, to Orr. Inside to Fevers. Oh, that's a big hit there. And it was an important hit. Crucial there. The Giants are getting out of a head of steam. They've got a quick play of the ball and they're trying to get it out wide. And they could be in here in the corner unless they're held up. And they're in there over the line. Referee just checks if his linesman is in goal, judges. Dean, an important first score for the Giants.
Yes, they needed to score, didn't they? And say Gareth Schofield will be very happy the way they've come out in the second half. I think, you know, you can't take too much away from Leeds there. Their defence has been under a lot of pressure, some consecutive sets of six. They've held for the most part, but there's some good ball movement by Huddersfield, and it was a very good try.
Kept the ball alive very well on the left-hand side.
Yeah, but all credit to Huddersfield, they've been in this in the Leeds half for, since the kickoff, more or less. A field, though, unfortunately for Leeds, is them couple of substitutions that's been forced upon us. They've just unbalanced the team at the moment, and they've not really settled back into a pattern.
Thanks, Bob. We'll go, of course, back down to Bob throughout the second half. Hopefully it will be in more celebratory manners when the Rhinos scoring tries. But that was a great try, well worked by the Giants. They've done well in this second half. Gary Scofield's obviously had stiff words in the dressing room, and they've came out with a game plan.
Yeah, I think what Leeds have got to be careful of at the moment, and it's probably going on for the last 5 minutes, is the amount of offloads that they're conceding. And it's certainly something that is very difficult to maintain a good defensive line when you're sort of backpedaling all the time due to offloads.
Certainly is a problem with the offloads. We've seen it so often this season. You can have the tightest defensive line, but if an offload comes and a player can get through, and as we say that, the kick missed there. So the Giants really need to capitalise on all point scoring opportunities.
And they certainly show that they can make a game of it as well. And Gary Schofield will be pleased with that. This again is another test for Leeds. Every game they play is a test. This is a different kind of test. And see how they respond to a short kickoff. And Huddersfield regathered it as well for Andy Cheatham.
Yeah, I don't think it was a planned short kickoff. It was one of those sort of off the side of the boot jobs. But fortunately, Huddersfield have got the ball back.
Well, Connolly's blown up for. He's going to have a word with his touch judge now. He's seen something that he didn't like the look of, and it's a knock-on by Giants. Well, Gary Schofield will be ruining that mistake. He sent his team out for a game plan. They've gone and done it. They've got the early score. They got a kickoff, fortunate kickoff. They've got the ball back, and then they go and knock on. And really, you can't have that sort of play and hope to succeed against this Leeds Rhinos side. And as we speak, that Iestyn Harris comes across. Offloads to Francis Cummins, who's moved into the centres now. Francis, where he got most of his appearances for the Rhinos.
Morley and McDermott giving Leeds go forward up to their own 30-metre line. But the Huddersfield defence is staying strong. They've got three men in there, and they've held up Adrian Morley.
Adrian Morley will be looking for a big game now. He's seen that Andy Hayes put a note of intention.
Big hit by Dave King on Fleary as well. Good tackle.
The Giants line up, cut up very quickly there. And the Rhinos will have to capitalise on this. The famous backward walk there from Richie Blackmore. We've seen that once or twice this season. There's a lot of, dearie me, Giants, you can't do that. Messing around the play the ball there.
Yeah, I'm glad the referee had seen that, because just at the moment, the Giants are slowing the Leeds play the ball down, which was obviously what they're trying to do. But at the same time, they're doing it illegally, and there's quite a few flops going on.
Tony Russell having words there with John Connolly, but I think he was just trying to make the most of a bad situation there, and John Connolly was up with none of it. He laughed off the Claims there from the Huddersfield contingent that was a forward pass, but John Connolly was well on hand there, right in front of it.
Yeah, I think Leeds were very lucky to get away from that, because that did look forward.
Andy Hay takes up now in the middle of the park. Plenty of options either way. Darryl Powell in at dummy half to Holroyd. First receiver, he takes it up. Bit of a flop there maybe from Neil Harmon. He knows that Ollie can get on his feet pretty quickly, so he wanted to make sure he stayed down there. Morley the dummy runner there, Harris jinking. Holroyd again, he's only got the fullback to beat, he's underneath the post. Well done, Graham Holroyd there, didn't go for the second effort, which would have gave away the ball. His momentum stopped him short, and that's where he stayed. Adrian Morley, he's on the park now, looks to go from the dummy half. Lost the ball, perhaps. Yes. That was unfortunate there, it was a good attacking platform for the Rhinos, Phil.
It was, but a good scrambling defence from Huddersfield. They had two, three men onto Adrian Morley quickly, and he's just shown that he's not quite adjusted to the pace of the game at the moment, just knocked on in his eagerness to go for the line. But a good move, again, some gaps appearing in the Huddersfield ranks, and Graham Holroyd thrice nearly exploiting them. Again, it's Huddersfield bringing the ball away from their own line. And Matt Sturm in possession about 10 metres away. He meets Darryl Powell, who drives him down into the turf. And Leeds need to keep Huddersfield pen into their own quarter if they can. Again, Jamie Field getting the ball out of the tackle to Danny Russell, and they've got over that 20-metre line. And it's taken a good tackle from Darryl Powell again to bring Huddersfield down. Hanger goes from acting halfback. He runs into the arms of Morley and McDermott.
This is good play by the Rhinos. They're managing to keep the Giants, who are very excitable in this second half, really looking very dangerous. But that's great tackling there from Farrell and Kemp on Chris Orr, and they'll have to kick the Giants from well inside their own half. It bounces once, Harris leaves it, he's got Sterling inside, and that's a famous little flip move they used there. Sterling takes it up another 10 yards. We're just hearing now that the from the authorities here at Headingley, the attendance is 13,144. That's a great attendance as Marcus Saint-Hilaire breaks in. He'll go all the way. Marcus Saint-Hilaire from the halfway line. What a man. A youngster who's made his way into the team, and he must have been going at some pace there, and he just stopped at the right angle and came underneath the post. What a young player is, what a young talent against his former club. That's a lovely try, and he'll be the happiest man in Leeds tonight, Dean.
Yeah, I think that try's been coming for a number of weeks now. Every time Marcus has been put into battle, he's managed runs like that. This time he went all the way, and it was just the result that that Leeds needed at the moment.
Again, we saw him do it to Sheffield. It was his 40-metre break from the back that brought the Leeds team the confidence to go on and win against Sheffield. I think that's going to give the team to go on and win this match. That was a fantastic break from, just inside his own half. He rounded Paul Cook, and Paul Cook's no slouch. Didn't get anywhere near tackling Marcus Saint-Hilaire on a superb run round to the post.
A beautiful try there, Bob.
Yeah, a terrific try, and he must be certainly pleased because it's against his original former club, of course. And I'm sure I can swear in the last 30 metres his feet didn't touch the ground.
Certainly, when he gets moving there, the legs go really fast, and he covered that ground with the greatest of ease. At one point, it looked like the covering defence might have got him, but then he just pulled away, slipped into another gear, and it was a good run and good play for the Rhinos, and much needed, Bob.
Yeah, this ball's right back into the game now. I can't see Huddersfield coming away again to score. I would think after that try, we bang on top and we'll stay there now.
And the Giants try to take it out from the half.
Yeah, I think Leeds will be inspired by that try now, and it'll take a big effort for the Giants to even bring the ball away from their own line. And the Leeds Rhinos at the moment, they look very fired up, and I'm sure there's a few more points on that's going to be on the board by the end of the game.
Again, it's somebody else coming off the bench and putting pressure for places. It's just that vital squad feeling that Leeds have got at the moment. Everybody who is given a half chance has got to make the most of it, and Marcus Saint-Hilaire was flying then.
Certainly a vital try. Ryan Sheridan looking like he's going to come back onto the field. As Harris chases back a kick.
Good positional play from Harris, and two great steps away from Danny Russell. And it was worth the admission fee for that sidestep, to be honest.
Two lovely, lovely steps there from Iestyn Harrison, showing us all the skill that we know he has, and every week he seems to pull something new out of the top drawer.
Well, those are the things that that you want out of your star players, and the things that you can't coach. I mean, that was a brilliant effort there by Iestyn. A great offload by Barry McDermott. Oh, there's one that Faz has held at the moment, and I think as I said before, it's just a matter of time before the floodgates open. Iestyn running from dummy half here, making a good break. Stirler's got the ball. He's show his pace now. And a great run by Stirler.
Good run by Paul Sterling there as he comes back inside. Always worries defences because of his space and his ability to cut down defenders and get really inside. And that's a great offload there. And Ryan Sheridan could be under the post. He is. Well done, Richie Blackmore. Ryan Sheridan only just back on the pitch.
As I say, you've got to credit Ryan Sheridan there. He's just put a scrum cap on because he's been obviously out of head wound. Comes on the sideline, and the first time he touches the ball, it's in support to Richie Blackmore, and he's under the post, and Leeds have, again, dominated in a two-minute spell.
Yeah, Huddersfield have really got to keep their heads up at the moment. They look a little bit dejected behind the try line, and they've got to make sure they keep these points down. They've really got no chance of winning the game, but the mood that Leeds are in, they've just got to watch their the points difference.
You're saying that Graham Holroyd pointed out to me in the build-up to this game that the players were already looking at the points differences, and Wigan have been racked up a couple of points, and as we see Darrell Powell coming off to be replaced by not playing in the side this week, but he's doing the talking for Graham Murray down the bench, and perhaps one of the easier games he'll have.
It could be harder, could be doing a lot more running.
Seems to be a bit of a general there, and passing on the orders.
Again, two tries in 2 minutes in the first half, and now in the second half, Leeds in total control at 30 points to four. And again, that was a great combination of moves. It was Iestyn Harris's superb sidestep that started it. Then he turned up again in the middle of the park to free Paul Sterling, and then Richie Blackmore's strength. He gave the offload, and a wonderful try. And again, Huddersfield trying to get out of their own half. I think the last 5 minutes since they scored, actually, they haven't been out of their own half.
This kick's going deep. We'll just go over the Leeds' 10 as it heads towards the try line. But Iestyn Harris, what's he going to show us this time? What's a little spin and a pass? Oh, it was a bit risky there, Iestyn.
That was brave.
But that's confidence for you.
You might say brave, it could be a little bit foolish as well.
I think it will be but Mark has taken it.
Kemp to Glanville. He takes it up. He'll take it up all day. Great leader of the team, as so many of them are out there. Adrian Morley, great offload from Adrian Morley, just what we've come to expect. To Holroyd, Cummins takes that out of the air, and he's got there to race the run, and he's pulled down on the 45, the Giants 45. A good run there by Cummins. He took it was above his head, but he brought it down, and now it comes across. Kemp, a little inside pass to Morley, he looks for the offload as per usual, gets it. Tackle counts back to zero. Goes across now. Marcus Centenaire, he'll like another one, please. But he's taken down. And it's a penalty to the Rhinos. They're getting a bit tetchy now, the Giants.
Yes, there's a Huddersfield player on there, and the physio has just motioned to the bench that they need to stretch her. So I'm not too sure who it is. It could be Phil Beavers if he's back on the park. Yes, even the Leeds physio is calling for a stretcher now. So. Unfortunate these things happen, but at the moment Leeds are just in full control, and you know, it was a great piece of running there by Francis Cummins. You know, he took a very difficult ball with ease, sidestepped the fullback, but a good cover defence by the Huddersfield inside defence managed to snuff him out.
I think Huddersfield are probably going to have problems on their bench as well, because their resources are looking a bit thin.
Paul Sterling coming across to the bench now.
Yeah, I'd actually be interested, Bob, in seeing what Leeds' resources are like as well at the moment. I've noticed that Graham Murray's made a few changes of late.
Looks as though Adrian Morley is on for Anthony Farrell and Martin Masella on for Tony Kemp. I think Leeds have probably got one substitution left. It does look like Phil Beavers has been in the wars tonight.
Bob, have you got any news for us on there? Are they just tactical substitutions?
Well, it just looked like it. I mean, he's been doing that with Tony in the last four or five games, hasn't he? In the last 20 minutes, just bringing him off and moving Iestyn up to number six. And he'll drop Marcus Centenaire back to number one. It's worked well for the last few weeks, so why not carry on?
Thankfully, no need for the stretcher there. As Mark Glanville takes it up, offloads to Sheridan. That's mark of this lead side in the last 10 minutes, so a lot of offloads. Blackmore comes inside. It's a lovely pass from Blackmore to now Morley all the world. Oh, dearie me. What's he called there, John Connolly? I think he said that the ball went forward.
No, he actually said that... actually, you might be right, but I thought he actually pulled him up for a, or Adrian running behind one of his own men, but that would have been a tough call anyway, because there's no way the Huddersfield defender would have got to him.
So the Giants have the feed.
Seems that the formula tonight is Leeds score three tries and then have two disallowed. But it certainly would have been double the lead if all these tries had stood.
The line just appeared to Adrian Morley there. It was a great little move. And some lovely interchange passing there. And just unfortunately get pulled up by the referee.
Yeah, some great defence at the moment by Leeds. Every tackle's driving Huddersfield back at the moment. And they'll be getting pretty frustrated.
So now the Giants try to move it. Matt Sturm takes it up the middle of the park. He's become less involved in this second half, probably because of his poor performance in the first half. Often players can become sheltered in games and look to protect themselves.
Yeah, there's five tackles there from Huddersfield and they've made about 17 metres. And now a great chase by Adrian Morley. All in all, they've probably made 10 metres and six tackles.
Fabulous work by the Rhinos there. And we talk about defence this season, about this Rhino side, but really, you saw it there in just microscopic detail. In the Giants' 20-yard area, great defence as Barry McDermott ploughs his way towards the corner post on the south stand side there. That's how close the Rhinos are. Five yards out.
Oh, and the Giants are up for a great tackle by Neil Hartman.
He's up there now, Holroyd, across the middle of the park. Just bounces and bobbles, and Paul Sterling picks it up and he arcs his way back inside, makes it to the 20, offloads to Francis Cummins, who's come over to this side. Got no support though, so he just runs in for the tackle. Ryan Sheridan at dummy half, he's got Iestyn to his right, and Darren Fleary coming across there as well in support. Will Harris need him, offload out there.
Again, that will be a put into Leeds because it came off Andy Cheatham's hand.
Rather naive play there, would have gone out anyway.
Yeah, that's right. Francis Cummins has enjoyed the extra work that he's got in the centre since Brad Godden went off, and he's looked very sharp.
Here the attendance announced at the ground to polite applause from the supporters here. It's great to see 13,000 for a team that are bottom of the Super League, and that's the measure of the lead support this year. They've all turned out, and if you listen at home, make sure you get down to Henley. It's really fantastic atmosphere here this year in Super League, as Graham Holroyd feeds the scrum for Richie Blackmore. There's another drinking run. He'll have to make sure he comes in, and he's gone out of play there. It's unfortunate they had the scrum, and they'll go back to exactly the same place, but this time it will be head and feed to the Giants. It's unfortunate for Richie there. I think he was waiting for Paul Stern to come back inside for him.
Yeah, it was unfortunate for Richie. You know, he backed his strength to try and use that blind side, but you know, he'd be very disappointed going out in the first tackle.
Again, it was a good tackle though by Danny Arnold. He's not shirked anything tonight.
All credit to the Giants. We thought that maybe the heads would drop after that last try for the Rhinos, but it hasn't. And now they've got a break on.
Gap up in the middle for Chris Orr, and he's done well.
Good jinking run there from Chris Orr. And a good defence from the Rhinos again. Just when you think a gap's opened up, it gets closed just as quickly by this Rhinos defence. They're working as a unit. Now Chris Orr has the ball again. It comes across, and that's a big hit from Richie Blackmore in the middle of the park. That takes that ball back nearly 10-15 yards from where the original pass came from. Neil Harmon now. Now it's Dave King off to Danny Arnold. Danny Arnold, he's got Paul Sterling chasing him. He hasn't seen him. Oh, down, Danny Arnold. Do you not see Paul Sterling? He took you down well and clean. A fabulous tackle from Paul Sterling. He's had a great game tonight on this defensive side. And now, but the Giants have got an overlap now on the other side. Marcus St. Hilaire can cover the tackles. And that's turnover. Really, the Giants should have moved the ball quicker there. They had the overlap. The Rhinos were on the back foot and they couldn't capitalise on it. And that they'll rue those chances in the final analysis of this game. So now the Rhinos have it there.
Great tackle from Paul Sterling there. That really sums up his night tonight.
Superb tackling by Paul tonight. And I know you have to pick yours for the League Express tackle.
That was it at the moment.
I think it's Paul Sterling are in the running so far. That's gone backwards. Andy Hay offloads to Martin Masella. The Rhinos 35 metres out from their own post. Goes across towards the south stand side. Graham Holroyd, a jinking run. He's got a hole. He could go all the way here. He's got support. He's got loads of support. And it's... Oh, that's a lovely ball inside from Graham Holroyd. All credit to him. Fabulous ball back inside to Francis Cummins. And that's a great, it's his second try of the night and really richly deserved.
Yeah, so it was a great try for Francis Cummins, but obviously all the work was done by Graham Holroyd. He just sliced through the Huddersfield defence as though it wasn't even there. I don't even think they got a hand to him, but full credit to him. He's seen that we were going nowhere. There's a few offloads, but we weren't having any go forward. He took the initiative, he took the ball forward, broke the line with ease, and passed a great ball inside to Francis Cummins. As you say, he's had a very good game.
Yeah, again, you've got to say that two of the old men there for Leeds, Holroyd and Cummins, been here for quite a while, still youngsters, but again, the Leeds passing is going nowhere there in midfield, and all of a sudden, Graham Holroyd was decisive. He saw the half gap, he backed his pace, Huddersfield didn't have a sweeper, he took on the fullback. It looked as though perhaps he was going to try and make it to the corner, but two Leeds players shot out of nowhere on support. The one nearest to hand was Francis Cummins, who's had a really top game tonight, and he just flew in by the post from a move over 50 metres that was of top quality.
Yes, it's caps a wonderful season for Francis so far. That's his fourth try of the season, two in this match, doubles his account for the year. As the Giants try to gain something out of this match, really now it's beyond them. But they've got a hard season, the Super League ahead of them. They've got to try and work the team moves, and you won't get a harder test than the Rhinos. And if they can come out of this, their head held high. They haven't given up. All credit to them. A lot of pride in the city. And they've broken away now, as I say that. And a good tackle there by Francis Cummins again. Russell tries to go across. He's got the ball out. Grissell gets the pass away. Dean Hanger has the ball there. And he's pulled down 5 metres short. Come across the rest of the way. Orr sees the Rhinos liner came up and he goes for it himself. Backs himself for his pace. Russell outside again. And he's gives the pass out behind her. Wanders out of play there.
Yeah, good defence by Marcus St. Hilaire there. He had a few men coming at him, but he managed to slide onto his winger and just nudged him out onto the sideline there by the corner flag. But Huddersfield put some good passing together there, and you just got to stay away because, I mean, obviously they're playing for a lot of pride at the moment.
Yeah, so they're not going for damage limitation. They're certainly trying to keep the ball alive, and that was a good move. But again, the difference between the two teams, Huddersfield have had two chances in the last 4 or 5 minutes, didn't come up with a try on either of them. Leeds have had one chance and scored 6 points from it.
Now they come away from underneath their own posts. Good running from Andy Hay. Richie Blackmore now. He makes it up to the 20, looks for the offload to Sterling, sides better of it. And they're trying to pull him towards the touchline, but he goes down well. Sheridan to Masella. Masella, Jinkin run, makes it to the 30. The Giants looking to make another substitution. Tony Bowers looking to come back on. Offload to Fleary. Fleary, he makes the halfway line. He won't go all the way. It's a good run there.
Yeah, great pass there by Barry McDermott. He's had a very good game because obviously the pace of the game would be hard for him to handle after playing the second division standard. And he's coped very well.
As we say that, Iestyn Harris makes another break. He's got Paul Sterling. Oh no, it's Graham Holroyd. And he backs his own pace and he managed to get round Neil Harmon, his old teammate. And there's no one that would be more upset with that than Neil Harmon. Graham Holroyd brushed him off and went underneath the sticks.
Again, I think Huddersfield were looking for the obstruction that wasn't there. But you've got to credit Leeds. We were just talking about the difference in finishing. Huddersfield had a chance in the corner, couldn't take it. Within, what, six sets of tackles? Barry McDermott's offloaded on halfway. Iestyn Harris has taken the ball on. Graham Holroyd took a pass that he had no right to take. And from 30 metres, his strength has carried him over. And Leeds are up to 40 points already.
Yes, Graham Holroyd, a tremendous try there. But you know, if you were Gary Schofield, you'd be very, very disappointed in the defence. He had a number of players around him, but they all hung off him and he just sliced through again.
Yeah, it's great play by Graham Holroyd, who's capped two wonderful games for the Rhinos, last week at St Helens, and again tonight. He's been in top form. A great young player with a great future for the Leeds club. Now, Iestyn Harris, another great young player. We often forget how young these players are.
He's not missed a kick tonight. Yeah, he's absolutely perfect.
Another one slotted over. And that's what it's all about. You've got to punish teams. And by getting your full complement of points with every try, then that's, you can't hope any more than that.
I think you've got to say again that there were players coming off the bench that made that try. Barry McDermott offloading on the halfway line, and then Adrian Morley keeping the ball alive to Iestyn Harris. And everybody, even Graham Holroyd, who's only in the last, 2 weeks cemented his place in the team. They're going to make some really interesting selection dilemmas for next week for Graham Murray. So Huddersfield again try and bring the ball out, and Neil Harmon, who's had an interesting night, meets Darren Fleary, and there was only one winner, and it wasn't Neil Harmon.
Yeah, Neil's tried, as he always does, you know, very hard tonight, and obviously the hooker, Danny Russell, you know, he is a class act, and he really just needs more support around him.
I'm hearing that Iestyn Harris only needs one more goal for 300 career goals. So that's certainly an aim. He came into the game needing eight. It's an eight of personal goals that come out in games like this. It comes across the Giants trying to, and he comes back inside, a good pass in the end. Danny Cheatham takes it and maybe ruins it, but Danny Russell.
It's the last tackle, and Danny Russell has to kick for touch. And it did come off Paul Sterling, but it'll be out on the full and the turnover, I would think.
I think we'll be looking for the man on the match soon. I think there must be three people in with a chance tonight. That's all right, Cummins in here on my way of seeing the game tonight.
And who would you call it out of the three, Bob?
I'd call it for Francis Cummins.
Well, I think Andy just might sneak it, because he did it when it was hard early doors.
Well, I'll disagree with all of you, and I'll give it to Graham Horrell.
It must have been a good team performance if we've got three different men of the match.
Give me a minute, I'll think of another.
And they're all emerging lads.
Good work by Richie Blackmore there as he comes back in the offside. Inside from Andy Hay. Now Fleary to McDermott. Back inside to Harris. Outside now to Holroyd. There's an overlap there. If Marcus Sinclair can take a cut, oh, he can. And he gets his second for the night. Well done, Marcus Saint-Hilaire, against his former club. He really, and that's a different try to the first one he got. That was a break. And that time he was in his winger's role, just staying on the outside. The overlap came from good work in the middle. From one side to the other, Hay, Blackmore, across to McDermott and Fleary, and then Harris all the way across to Holroyd. And then Saint-Hilaire in the corner. A great try for the Rhinos.
Yeah, it certainly was a great try. But what Richie Blackmore does so well, he takes a lot of tackling, and he's always attracting defenders, but he always gets a quick play the ball. And that's what the end result was that try.
Aims to achieve on teams not only big hits to tie defences, but quick play the ball. You've got defences constantly on the back foot, constantly worrying, and that's exactly what Richie Blackmore did there, creating an overlap on the opposite side of the field.
The kick's yes, over. Harris.
And that's it. You hear the PA announcer announce it as well. 300 career goals, yes, now. It's a marvellous milestone for someone so young.
Yeah, I've just got a feeling that he might get a few more as well.
Even tonight. And there's only 5 minutes left. We were saying before the game that class teams tend to pull away late on, and you'd have to say tonight that Leeds have looked so strong in these last, 10 minutes. They've really, really dominated, and there's very little, if anything, that Huddersfield can do about it at the moment. Huddersfield attempting to bring the ball out. Jamie Field's still out there. He's tried his hardest.
None of these Huddersfield players can be faulted for their effort. They've all tried well in this game, but they've just been hitting up against a brick wall in this Leeds Rhinos side. No one epitomises that more. Then Andy Hay put a big crunching tackle in there, and Darren Fleary and Mark Glanville there, and followed it up. And now the Giants come across. They'll look to get a consolation try surely now. But Barry McDermott and Richie Blackmore in the tackles.
And Huddersfield have got forwards playing out on the wing at the moment. They are in a bit of disarray as Chris Orr hoists that kick, which Iestyn Harris takes, and runs round Danny Russell and comes back inside and beats him again. And it's another 40-metre pass to Marcus Saint-Hilaire. And you wouldn't back him against going all the way.
Just caught there. Chris Orr just grabbed his shirt, and it was enough to slow him down for the cover tackle to come in. But Iestyn Harris now looks to create.
You wouldn't want to suffer an injury in the side at the moment, would you? Because as soon as you do, someone steps in your place. And obviously Marcus Saint-Hilaire has put his hand up tonight to be selected next week.
he's done a great job as well.
Another match just being announced now. Who will it be? Andy Hay gets it, and that's great reward for a magnificent play.
Man of the match chosen by Bob Pickles, though.
Congratulations, Bob. You've done it again.
Yeah, thank you. I thought Andy might be in with a shout there. His early performance, like I said, was when the going was out.
Let's kick through, and St Hilaire takes it well on the 10. Good chasing, though, from the Giants. They're not giving up anything. St Hilaire just took a knock there.
You feel on St Hilaire's performance tonight that if he'd have been playing regular games at Leeds, he'd have been in this emerging England team.
You get the feeling with many players in this side that perhaps the five Andy Goodway chose, and he thought he couldn't pick many more, he'd be playing our side, really. Certainly Ryan Sheridan and Anthony Farrell were unlucky to miss out on call-ups.
You said that the benchmark tonight was probably Wigan's 46-0 beat over Huddersfield. And Cummins is away, and Leeds could top that. He should go in the corner.
Great tackle, Paul Cook. Paul Cook sized him up from nearly 10 yards away there and put the tackle in right in the corner.
Yeah, well, I think what saved the certain try, because it was Ryan Sheridan in support, was a defender coming across, and he got in between Ryan Sheridan and Francis Cummins.
But Iestyn Harris goes under now. And there it is. The regular as clockwork, Iestyn Harris chomps up with one of his tries. And that was perhaps one of the easier ones he'll get this season. He just had to walk over from 2 yards, but they all count at the end of the day, and they'll all make this victory even the sweeter for the Rhinos.
Yes, it must be a forward's nightmare seeing Iestyn Harris coming at you. You're on the back foot, and which way is he going to step? And I think it's just reward for Iestyn. Hasn't been one of the standout players tonight, but everything he's done with a class.
And just looking at the times of the tries, Leeds have scored 67, 72, 75, 79 minutes. And we were saying that the benchmark was the Wigan score of 46-0. If Iestyn Harris kicks this goal, that would make it 54-4. And you'd have to say that that again sends out a message to the rest of the rugby league. Everybody said Leeds had it to do tonight. They were the favourites, different kind of pressure. You can't do more than beat your opposition by a margin of 50 points.
Graham Murray must be a very happy man with his team's performance. As the final hooter goes and the players come in to a standing ovation, they've returned home after two successful away trips to treat their fans to a marvellous performance tonight. It was only 18-0 at half-time, but in the second half, the Rhinos cut loose. It wasn't before the Huddersfield Giants got the first try on the board with Dean Hanger, but then the Rhinos hit back as if scorned. With tries from St Hilaire, lovely break from halfway. Sheridan coming in off the bench. Cummins getting his second. Graham Holroyd, a lovely runaround try that got in and under the post from 30 yards out. St Hilaire going in the wing. And finally, capping it all, the captain himself, Iestyn Harris, went over. And he scored every single conversion tonight. A marvellous performance, 100% for Iestyn Harris. Getting himself a total career goals of 301. And that is a marvellous target for the young man. So it's a final score of 54-4, and Graham Murray must be happy with that, Dean Bell.
Well, you've got to be happy. I know Graham really at the start of the game would have just wanted the 2 points, but secretly I have been speaking to him during the week. He wanted to win in style, and that's what you've got to do. And that's what we've said even before tonight's game is there's a different kind of pressure. Those expectations are high at the moment, and boy, they didn't disappoint tonight.
It certainly didn't. 54-4 marks a superb result for the Rhinos. They've done well out there. They knew there was a job to be done, and they've done it. And that's the mark of champions. If there is such benchmarks to go by, you have to beat sides that are on the out there to be beaten, and they've done that tonight, and they won convincingly. And they go back into the change rooms to a standing ovation, and they'll travel to Hull next week confident of a win. And then they're back here against Halifax in a fortnight on Friday night.
I think the important thing is they've got to keep faith with this fantastic support base that they've got. They came here tonight perhaps expecting Leeds would win and wanting to see a show, and in that last 10 minutes Leeds have not only shown their class, but the entertainment has been fantastic. Graham Holroyd and Iestyn Harris absolutely tore Huddersfield apart in that last 10 minutes, and Leeds are the team to watch in Super League at the moment.
And we'll leave you here from Headingley as Barry McDermott is the last player to leave the field, and he gets a special stand ovation. It's a great win for the Rhinos, 54-4 against the Huddersfield Giants, and a lovely atmosphere, over 13,000 here tonight. So join us later on Radio Rhino as we review the whole match in detail.
Graham, fantastic achievement tonight, a superb result and a real clinical performance from the guys.
Yeah, it was, and I thought a win like that was sort of coming along the lines. We'd played some tough matches lately, you know, Wigan, St Helens, Sheffield, London, they've all been pretty tough for us. So, I just thought we were going to open up on someone, and unfortunately for Huddersfield, it was them tonight.
And it's always nice to do it at Headingley in front of the home fans here.
Yeah, it's a good win here, you know, they're a great bunch to support us the way they do, and even away games they support very well. So, you know, we're looking forward to every week here at Headingley, that support and away.
In the second half, we seemed to take real control of the game. That must have pleased you very much.
Yeah, there's a couple of errors I wasn't happy with, but I think basically we did control the ball pretty well. The game was out of their grasp, but we came up with some spectacular tries.
And again, another impressive performance from super sub Marcus Hilaire, going in for two tries.
Yeah, he's a terrific player, and he's been on the bench a fair bit, the young bloke, and I think he's such a quality player when he comes on. Every time he does something very, very good. And I could put him in the centres, I think, fullback, wing, and he'd still do a very good job for us.
Next week, we go and try and look for 10 out of 10 at the Boulevard. A lot of reputations there. You must have heard a lot about that ground.
Yeah, I've heard a lot about the Boulevard. It's never easy to win there. So, you know, the challenge is there for us to go to Hull and come over the points. It won't be easy, but none of them have been easy so far that I can see.
But it's great sitting on top of the league, 4 points clear of the rest.
Yeah, we're going very good. There's no doubt about that. And the support's terrific. And the club is going very good at the moment. The players have got their football heads on, and the whole club is buzzing. We couldn't be happier.
Thank you.
I don't know.